एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ शॉर्टिंग एल्गोरिथम, सो विच वी हैव टोल्ड दैट वी विल मेक अवर वीडियो इन द शॉर्टिंग एल्गोरिथम। सो टुडे शॉर्टिंग एल्गोरिथम इज बबल शॉर्ट। सो इन बबल शॉर्ट, सो ओके, आई विल गो वन ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल। सी, आई मैंशन वन एग्जाम्पल हेयर। सो वट वी आर गोइंग टू डू हेयर इज इन दिस कलेक्शन, सपोज आई हैव एन एरे where I have a numbers like 9, 2, 4, 1, 3, okay, and I want to sort this in a ascending order. So how can I sort it? So basically there are many sorting algorithms are present. So today we are, as we have a bubble sort, so we will solve this using the bubble sort algorithm. So how it is work is like, suppose I have 9, 2, 4, 1, 3, okay, so we'll go with the first element, okay, which is 9, and we'll, with the second element is 2. We compare with these two, okay, so what is there, 9 is greater than 2, right? So we just swap them here. So the string, my collection will be 2, 9, 4, 1, 3. In the next step, I am going to again the index 1, right? In the array we have 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4 index, so I will go in the second index, which is 1, and I will compare with the 4. So I will compare 9 with the 4, because we already compared 2 and 9, right? We swap them also. So 9 with the 4, is 9 is greater than 4? Yes. So what will be the position? Definitely it will be the where 4 it was there. It should be 4, 9, 1, 3. Yes. So this is the second steps. The third step, I will also compare like 2, which is 4, and I will compare 9, 1. Okay, is 9 is greater than 1? Yes, definitely it's greater than 1. So I will just swap them, right? I will just swap them here and it will be like 3. And so I went here the index 3. I will compare the index 3 number with the index 4. Index 3 is 9. Is 9 is greater than 3? Yes, definitely 3 greater than 3. So I will just swap them. So 2, 4, 1, 3 and 9. Right, so you saw that at the end I got the greater number, so it bubbles up, right? This is a one pass I did, and I got the ninth number at the end. So this is how bubble sort works. So this is a one pass, okay? So again, to sort this, I need to go again from the to this array, right? 2, 3. I will again compare 2 is greater than 4, it's not, so I won't swap. 4, 1, I definitely saw 1, 4, like this. So I will go like this up to the end, so definitely I will get the another number 2, 1, 3, 4, right? So 4 will be the second last element. So like this, all the elements will be the at the end, and at the end it will bubbles up. So what is the time complexity of this? Because I will go one by one, all two iteration, right? See, this is a one pass, like this I will go another pass. So one for loop I need to maintain for the passes, right? And in one loop I will just compare with the each number. So in the worst case scenario, what will happen, my time complexity will be O(n)2, right? O(n)2, I can say. So in the bubble sort, my time complexity will be O(n)2. So let's try to make this using C sharp. We'll just code it through C sharp and just see how it shorts our bubble short. So I will just create a static method here. I will just return an array, right? Shorted array. So I will just give a name here, bubble short. Okay. So in the input I will give my array here, which is like given. I can just put it here. You can put array, okay. So just given array, I will type it, right? Given array. So I will have one for loop, right? I will just put it one for loop here, and just how long it should go. It should go array dot. It should dot low array dot length, okay. And then I will have one more loop where I will go again. This is, as I told you, right, the first for loop where it will go for the passes, and another for loop will go to the comparison with the numbers. So it will go for a dot length, right? So this is there, yeah, that is fine here. and just I will now I need to swap them, right? So how I will do, I will just compare, okay, given array, okay, I will, or anyway I should I can I should start with the one, right? I need to compare with the, because this is for comparison, I need to go with the one index and just compare with this less than one index, right? It will be zero. So I will just compare, okay, if I of j, right, I of j is less than given array of j minus 1. If it is true, what I will do, I will just swap them, right? I will have given array of j and then given array of j, given array of j minus 1, right? Minus 1, I will just pass the given array of j. So how I will do, yeah, I will do, I just pass this here. I am just given array, right? In the this one I will just in the temporary array, and this in this whatever I'll do, I will just pass the j minus 1, correct? And in the given j minus 1, I will pass my temp. So I swiped my numbers, and just after end of this for loop, right, this for loop is getting here, and I will just return my given array, which should be in the sorted order. So let me just call the result here, and I will just go bubble short, and I will pass my array. I will just, okay, I will just create new array here. Input, I will just give it here. Int, basically, yeah, new int, and just I will give my order. So what numbers I follow? Example 92413. So let me pass it 9, 2, 4, 1, and 3. Okay, and just I will pass my input here. Okay, and for that result I need to print it also, right? So for each item I will go which will be my number in result. Definitely I will just pass the number here. Okay, so this is looks fine here, correct? Let me just run it and let's see the output. So we saw 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, right? It got shorted. So you can see, right, we just go, so this one you saw, right, in the for this for loop is just for the passes, because in the example you saw, right, in the first pass I need to cover this so that 9 will come again. I will need to go with this array because it is shorter again, then the 4 will pops up before 9, right? So these are the passes I need to go up to length, right? Or this is for the comparison I am doing. So in the this for loop you can see, right, I am going all the way to the length, right? But in the one pass it will be like 9, right? Another pass I just it will be 4, right? So I need to just minus the length, okay, so that it will it should not go in the end, it should not go in the end and just compare that, because this is already sorted, right? This 9 is already sorted. This is the position of the 9. So what can I do? I can just put the length minus 1, or not then the minus, I need just put the I, because in the first it I will be 0, right? I need to go again, then I will be 1, so I will minus 1. So I need to just short this up to this number, right? So this is one of the optimization I can do. So definitely I can just move this logic here, this logic I can just move it to the another method, that also optimization I can do. So this I am giving up to you, okay, as an exercise. So let's see, I just change it, right? Let's see is output is same or not. So you saw 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, definitely. So let me just test it with the other inputs. What will happen? I will have just two inputs. See, it will like 2 and 9, definitely very good. And if I pass it with the 9, let's see what will be the output. Let's see it, 9, definitely. And if suppose I am just doing, let's see what will the output here. It's building. See, it's an empty. So this is how what I will do. This is the way is the bubble short works. Okay. So if you have any question, you can write in the comment box. Okay, so we'll definitely answer for that. So this is how the shorting algorithm works. So in the next video we will come up with some other shorting algorithm. So if you like my videos, please like, share and subscribe, and yeah, please comment if you want in which topic you want to the next video. So we will definitely make a video for that using C sharp. So yeah, so thank you for watching this video, and please like, share and subscribe, and yeah, so let's see you guys in the next video.